look at this one. Edward Rutledge of Spring Valley, New York, walked backwards from Brooklyn to San Francisco.
Billy, turn to the guy with the longest fingernails.
What page?
Here it comes. Here it comes. Oh, there it is! Oh, gross! Gross! Look at that! Get it away from me! Get it away from me! I'm gonna throw up!
That's disgusting. Listen to this. Chester Woolcott, the human pretzel, was able to wrap his arms around his legs and his legs around his head.
That's simple. I can do that. I'm double jointed.
Gross. Hey, guys, it's easy. Where are you going? Hey, hey, where are you going? Hey, come back here.
Oh. Okay, I think I just pulled something. There goes the old back, and there goes the old groin. I'm getting too old for this kind of crap. Soon a brand new parking lot. They're gonna tear down my childhood playground. No. No. What kind of stinking nihilistic world are we living in?
That cute little squirrel. Hey, it has shaving cream all over its mouth.
Chris, get away from that. It has rabies.
Ow! No, not another giant needle in the stomach. Ow!
No, they're not gonna do this to me. This is my playground, damn it. This is part of my history. Part of all of Greenville's history. My very personality, heart and soul, had its genesis right here in this playground. This is where I learned about tolerance and about sharing and how to cruelly tease my peers. I was spawned from this golden soil, which now has glass in it. What about Billy and Eddie and Danny?
Help us, Chris, help us! Protect our future.
Please, please.
Don't let them deprive us of the kind of wonderful memories you had.
Save our playground. Please, please.
Help us, Chris, help us!
I will, boys, I will.
Help us!
I will.
Help us!
I will.
Help us!
I said I will. Stop nagging. I vow that as long as I breathe the filthy, stagnant air of this planet, Nothing shall come between me and my childhood playground. So then the assistant to the mayor's office sent me to the Greenville Landmark Society, and then from there I had to go to the town planning committee, and then after that to the Parks and Recreation Department, and from there to the pet store.
Why'd you go there?
I wanted to look at the little doggies. And then finally, the city council told me there just isn't enough money in the budget to maintain the playground. Can you believe that? It costs a lousy $300 a month. By my calculations, about $1,000 a year.
Actually, $3,600 a year.
Yeah, exactly. And they can't find the money in the budget to maintain it.
Well, Chris, let me tell you, in my day, if we saw something we didn't like, we'd rally together against the establishment. We'd demonstrate against the fuzz and burn our draft cards.
Dad, you're talking about the turbulent 60s. You grew up during the Depression.
Gladys, one of these days, we gotta put our Time Life March Through the Decades collection in the proper order. Will you make a note of that?
I just think it's terrible they're tearing down that old playground. Granted, for the last couple of years, it's been nothing but a rat-infested haven for drunken teenagers and a stomping ground for dangerous drifters, but every quaint small town needs a place like that.
Exactly, Ma. And that's why I'm gonna raise the money to save the playground.
Well, that sounds real noble, son.
Well, thanks, Dad. How about slipping me a couple of bucks as a donation towards saving the playground?
Oh, no. We're elderly people, Chris. We're on a fixed income. We don't have extra money around to squander on frivolities.
Oh, by the way, dear, if you're going by the Civic Center, would you pick up our tickets to the Jack Jones concert for tomorrow night?
Oh, great, Ma. I guess that's not a frivolity, huh?
Are you nuts, boy? We're talking about Jack freaking Jones.
Okay, I'll pick up the tickets. And now, it's off to save the playground.
Help us, Chris! Help us!
I will! Stop it! Leave me alone!
The best things in life are free, but you can keep them from the birds and bees. I want money.
What I want.
What I want.
That's what I want.
That's what I want.
That's what I want.
What I want.
That's what I want.
Your loving gives me a thrill, but your loving won't pay my bills. I need money.
What I want.
What I want.
That's what I want.
That's what I want.
What I want.
What I want.
That's what I want.
Money don't get everything, it's true. What it don't get,
they're tearing down our childhood playground. Oh, I'm sorry. Am I interrupting something here?
As a matter of fact, yes.
Oh, that's okay. You can thank me later, Larry. Larry, do you believe it? The playground. And no one in this town cares.
You mean the place where we became blood brothers?
Larry, I've tried everything to get the town to save this park. No one's interested. They're all caught up in their own little personal problems. All they care about is buying things for themselves. Clothing, food, medicine. I'm telling you, it's the me decade.
Chris, people are just basically apathetic. You need something to get their attention. You need a gimmick.
Yeah. Why don't you drink a bottle of Clorox or drive your car off a cliff? I'd pay to see that.
What if I broke some world's record? Larry, this, it's perfect. This guy broke the world's record for having stuff stacked on top of him. 2,000 pounds, that's a cinch. I can break that because I'm actually used to a lot of weight on me. Sometimes when I sleep at night, I use an extra blanket.
It's perfect. We'll charge people to put stuff on top of you. They'll come from miles around to lay something really heavy on your stomach. You know something, pal? You might just save this park after all. And who knows? They might even erect a statue in your honor.
Thank you, Chris. Thank you. 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 Thank you, Chris. Thank you.
Well, you're in perfect health for a guy who's probably gonna die this afternoon.
My blood pressure is okay and everything?
I don't know. Didn't think to check that.
You ready, buddy?
Yeah.
Okay, let's get started so we can build a crowd here. Assume the position. Okay. Doc, you wanna give me a hand over here?
Mm-hmm.
Bring it on. Okay.
Here we go.
And now, as your best friend, I'd like to be the first to place an item on top of you. Here's my money and a folding chair weighing 3.5 pounds. Ah! Oh, get it off! I quit!
Wait. Oh, that's much better. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, I guess it's all a matter of just distributing the weight properly. This is gonna be a cinch.
Oh, boys.
A refrigerator?
Not just a refrigerator.
Oh, my dear sweet God.
Dr. Kramer, I don't think Chris looks too good.
He looks okay to me. I just wouldn't give him any more tomato juice.
Yeah. Larry, it's very acidic. Wipe my mouth off, will you? I'm dribbling.
I do want to warn you boys again, though. This is a very foolish venture, and I can't condone any part of it. The next item that goes on this pile might very well kill him.
So are you saying we should just give up?
That's a hard call. It'd be a shame to quit after you've come so far.
Quit? Nobody's quitting. I'm not leaving here until I save this playground. Thank you. Thank you all very, very much.
Chris, that's not for you. They're applauding Ben Spangler. He's coming in with a huge tractor tire.
And so I proudly place this 373-pound tractor tire on top of the pile of death.
Larry, did we change the name of this event?
I think that's what the townspeople have affectionately dubbed it. Chris, listen to that. That's all for you, buddy. Isn't it wonderful to have this town behind you, supporting you all the way?
Blast it!
Larry, my worst fear has been realized. My knee itches.
Well, scratch it.
I can't reach it.
Dr. Kramer, what should we do?
Well, I could go in there with a coat hanger and try to scratch it for him, but it might kill him.
Larry, I've got to take that chance. There's a children's playground at stake here. Go ahead, sign the papers.
Out.
Oh, sorry. False alarm. Okay.
up. Push it, push it. A little harder, a little harder.
Peterson, is there a Chris Peterson here?
Here, down here. Hey.
My name is Harold Pitt, representative of the Big Book of World Records. We were notified that you were embarking on some sort of silly frippidum in an attempt to gain entry into our publication.
Yes, sir, and to raise money to save our childhood playground.
Yes, well, what sort of a record were you going for, laddie?
Well, I'm trying to break the world's record for having stuff stacked on top of me.
Aha! We have no such record in our book.
Well, you sure do. There's a picture right here on page 93.
I don't need to see the book, laddie. I know it by heart. And page 93 recounts a dreadful incident which you have obviously misread. In 1943, a gentleman by the name of Malcolm Kent attempted to break the world's record for pile stacking. Tragically, as Malcolm was hoisting a coal furnace on top, the pile collapsed. And Mr. Kent was trapped underneath his 2,000 pounds, forcing his internal organs out through his cake hole like so much tooth polish and sending him off to meet his maker. You see, boys, what you have there is a picture of the carnage afterwards, not the actual event.
I don't believe this.
You don't seriously think that we will condone such inane popery as this, do you? My lad could get killed.
That's exactly what I've been trying to tell him. Guess if you don't sound like the Beatles nowadays, no one listens to you.
Yes, well, I'm off to find a nice pub. Pot of tea, jam tart, and, Fiddy Pops.
Gee, Chris, you really blew this world record thing, huh?
Yeah, I guess so. But the more important thing is I'm gonna save this playground for you little tykes.
Playground? Who needs a playground? We just sit at home, drink Dr. Pepper, and watch MTV.
Boys, would you leave me alone with my thoughts for a while, please? Larry, let's just count up the cash and get the hell out of here. Yeah, sorry, folks, I did my best.
Chris, I got some bad news. We're a little short of the $3,600 that we needed.
Well, how short?
Well, actually, we only have $192.
Well, Larry, did you count it right?
I could count it again, but I don't think I missed $3,000.
Larry, how did this happen? What kind of an accountant are you?
I guess I should have charged a dollar a pound instead of a dollar an item.
Who would have ever thought the two of you could have screwed up something like this? I am shocked.
Chris, relax. I'll explain it to the townspeople. They're our friends and neighbors. They'll understand. Ladies and gentlemen, there's been a little misunderstanding. We meant to charge by the pound instead of by the item. For instance, Ben Spangler, you owe $372 more.
Go to hell.
No way.
Take a high cow.
Kill him!
He's a witch.
Larry, I failed. I failed. Oh, I failed.
Ugh. Now, hold on. I heard that. Let you and I have a little heart-to-heart, young man. If I didn't screw up your little death pile here.
Oh, who cares?
That's no kind of attitude to have. Let me tell you something. I know you tried to save the playground, but you didn't. So what? And you screwed up that world's record deal. So what? The important thing is that you tried. You gave it your all. Not a lot of people in the world that do that anymore. It's something to be proud of. I'm proud of you, and I love you, son.
Thanks, Dad. Gosh, I feel a lot better now.
I'm glad to hear that. Now, do you have those Jack Jones tickets?
We've been looking forward to that concert all week.
Yeah, I do. But the funny thing is, they're in my pants pocket, and there's no way I can get to them.
You are an idiot.
I can't believe it! It's Jack Jones!
Oh, hold me, Fred. I might faint.
What the hell is going on around here? I've been stuck in traffic for 20 minutes. What's everybody doing down here at the town dump?
Well, sir, we're trying to save our local playground from the wrecking ball.
Gee, Mr. Jones, are you here because you support this playground?
I don't know.
Well, you're not against the playground, are you?
But why would I be against the playground?
This sounds to me like a bona fide endorsement by a major entertainer. Gee, here's all the money I got. Mr. Jones? Jones, you know how you could really help us? If you'd sing a song.
Then will he move those damn cars?
Sure.
Let me have my charity event microphone. Call me irresponsible, call me unreliable, throw in undependable too. Do my foolish alibis bore you? Well, I'm not too clever, I just adore you. Call me unpredictable, tell me I'm impractical, rainbow I'm inclined to pursue. Call me irresponsible, yes, I'm unreliable, but it's undeniably true. I'm irresponsibly mad for you.
Oh! Chris, we did it. We have enough money to save the park.
Just a moment. I have an announcement to make.
Oh, great. Now we got the man from the Avengers.
It seems that a world's record has been set after all.
Oh, great. You mean I did it?
Not exactly. No, the record goes to Mr. Jack Jones, the only singer ever to perform atop a pile of rubbish stacked atop a rather silly man. It's a bit quirky, and perhaps I've had a few too many rum tooties, but at this late hour, it will have to do. Congratulations, Mr. Jones.
Thank you.
Hey, Mom, Dad, where's everyone going? Hey. Treasure Island. Oh, dear God in heaven, no. No! I'm really getting too old for this kind of crap.